Now, from WYDC-TV, this is Big Fox News at 10.
Good evening. I'm Scott Beadle with Big Fox News. Chemung deputies are investigating after an incident early this morning. Deputies were called to Collingwood Mobile Home Park around 6 o'clock for a man who claimed he was being followed. He was gone when they got there. Deputies say he got into a car and told the driver to take him to police. The woman was able to call 911, then later managed to flee her vehicle at Gardner Road and Wisteria Way. Authorities say the suspect then ran into a home and yelled for that resident to call 911, which they did. Horseheads police arrived and took him to a local hospital. His name is not being released. Charges are pending at this time. A new gun law goes into effect tomorrow in Pennsylvania that will force people with domestic violence rulings against them to surrender their guns. The new law requires anyone who has been served a final protection from an abuse order or has been convicted of domestic violence to surrender their guns within a 24-hour period. The old law allowed a 60-day surrender window and allowed defendants to give their guns to family or friends. Now defendants must give their guns to law enforcement, a firearms dealer, or an attorney. An Elmira taxi company is looking to find more employees in preparation for Woodstock 50 this summer. A three-day music festival is set to take place August 16th through the 18th and draw more than 100,000 people. That's why Total Transportation of Elmira is planning on upping the number of taxi cabs that they usually send for events at WGI for the weekend. The parent company for Total Transportation is Ithaca Dispatch, and in total, their fleet consists of 65 cabs. They're planning to send at least 20 to Woodstock 50. The company says it'll begin looking for more employees in order to meet the needs of the festival weekends. A program for senior citizens in Steuben County that was set to begin this month has been delayed. The program would provide home health care to senior citizens who qualify for Medicaid and return home after a stay in a nursing home. The program would include an emergency response system, assistance in accessing therapy, and activities like grocery shopping and laundry. That program has now been pushed back to 2020. We're looking at a downward slide in temperatures after hitting the 60s today. Meteorologist Kim Walker has more coming up next in your Big Fox forecast.
Now, your Twin Tiers forecast from Big Fox.
We started off with sunshine today, and we are going to see the sunshine by tomorrow, even though we're going to start off with some morning showers, gradually clearing, but temperatures will be a lot cooler than today, where we had highs around 70 degrees. Mostly cloudy conditions, though, on Thursday with another system coming through. There could be a few isolated showers in the afternoon, and then by Friday, we start to warm up. Scattered showers and thunderstorms will be possible, but for tonight, there could be some lingering showers mixing in with some snow as we head into the early morning hours. As you can see, the purple and the blue that will be showing up right there moving toward Elmira during the morning commute. So we do have that, not a lot of accumulation, and then we should see the sunshine win out as we head into the afternoon. But it will be a much cooler day as high pressure starts to build in, and we're talking about a 20 to 30 degree drop as we head into tomorrow. Tonight will be chilly, temperatures dropping down to around 34 degrees in Elmira, 36 in Corning. Mostly cloudy conditions. Again, there could be some showers, a wintry mix early in the day. And then as we head into tomorrow, those temperatures will be a lot cooler than what we had today. And it will be breezy with winds coming in from the north northwest. Highs tomorrow around 49 degrees in Elmira, 48 degrees in Corning. Mansfield around 49 degrees. But we should see some sunshine by the afternoon. Your 7-day forecast calls for a warming trend as we head toward the end of the week. 67 degrees on Friday with the possibility of showers and a few thunderstorms, drying out on Saturday, and then we start to cool down again as we head into early next week with another storm system that will bring the possibility of showers our way. That's a look at your weather, Scott.
All right, thank you, Kim. Well, it's not every day that you see an alligator cross the road, but that is what happened yesterday morning at Morrell's Inlet in South Carolina. This big gator crossed the causeway at the Huntington Beach State Park. Now, what's amazing about this, as you see there, that alligator is actually using the pedestrian crosswalk. That was his stuff. No jaywalking here. Thanks for joining us on Big Fox News. Have a great night.